Chairman KCFR, Mr. Kransagel, to welcome the participants.
We are very blessed that the President of Pakistan, Mr. Arif Alvi, will join us for the plenary address, and I thank him for taking time out for this important event.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. His Excellency Mr. Yao Jing, Ambassador of People's Republic of China, Chairman CPEC Authority, Lieutenant General Asim Saleem Bajwa Sahab, Chairman Karachi Council on Foreign Relations, Mr. Ikram Sehgal. In the world, always, peace was related to the fact that there were trade routes. War always disrupted trade routes. So China and Pakistan had was the Great Silk Road, which was re-established through the Karakoram Highway. As long as there is movement of goods, there is prosperity, there is trade between regions. If there is one region in that, one country in that region which is more economically prosperous, it is able to import goods from less prosperous regions. And therefore, the Belt and Road Initiative, which China, the government of China and the People's Republic of China has initiated throughout the Southeast Asia as well as towards Central Asia, and then through Pakistan, the CPEC corridor is very important.
We appreciate the Chinese government and the people, appreciate a lot for the solidarity support and the assistance from the Pakistani government and the people when China was suffering from the outbreak.
CPEC is a transformational project. It is a game changer for Pakistan.
It's not really important only for this region. It changes the geopolitical dynamics of this whole region. Just to give you a little background, why did Japan go to war in World War II? Japan went to war in World War II because the resources that was used to in Southeast Asia were denied by the naval power of, at that time, the predominant British and US forces. Now, Japan had no recourse but to go to war. Obviously, after that, the fleets became very important. And because the fleets became very important, there was no real land routes available, the BRI changes the dynamics, the geopolitical dynamics of the whole world.
CPEC corridor, there are 20, about 19 projects which have been completed. There are about 28 which are in the phases of implementation. There are 41 in the pipeline, and this will keep on getting bigger and bigger.
Several projects, especially in the area of construction, has been approved and started. For example, that our hydropower stations in both Kohara and Pattan, and also that right now we are engaged in a very close coordination and discussion about the implementation of the mainline railway project.
CPEC was planned in three phases. Phase one, which was the early harvest, and phase one, short-term projects, was basically meant to fill the gaps in our infrastructure, both in communication and energy.
In this global pandemic, from China, the foreign direct investment is coming to Pakistan. Instead of all the criticism Pakistan and China is facing, we have to do our best.
We have made a lot of progress on the CPEC. It's a $62 billion ultimately a project which will keep on expanding as prosperity increases and as the needs for communication through rail, through fiber, through road, through energy, through pipelines and all kinds of trade. As those routes become more popularized, we will have to keep on improving upon them and increasing that infrastructure and increasing the reach of the same.
Now you can go from Shanghai to Paris by road and rail in 15 days, but it takes you 45 days by sea to take something. Now, obviously, number one. Number two, there can be no interdiction the way the interdiction could be possible in the seas.
The environment in the region is improving by the day, and Pakistan is becoming in the center of all this development of peace and prosperity, becoming visible in our lifetime.
And the General Bajwa also mentioned that. And that is our industrial cooperation, agricultural cooperation, and other science and technology, including other sectors like the tourism and water resources management. All these, I think, they are very important. And I think we are in close collaboration with the various departments and the ministries.
We have to get ready now to take full advantage of this.
Second is that under the social sector, we are going to shift more resources to deal with the immediate challenges, for example, regarding the prevention and control and also the treatment of the COVID-19 cases.
That is a great thing. The other thing which, let me say, is of great importance to Pakistan and the region is the development where Shah Bahar has been taken over, in the sense of at least the development of Shah Bahar in Iran has been now with the Chinese, and also the energy project the Chinese have taken over. In effect, technically, today, it has become the China-Pakistan-Iran economic corridor.
There are four areas that we are focusing. Number one is mass industrialization through special economic zones. There are a total of 9 zones which were to be built, and we are working on 3 prioritized zones, one in Rashakai, one in Faisalabad, and one in Dhabiji next to Karachi.
As the special economic zones come up, as the tax haven which have been created in Gwadar and other places along the corridor, as these tax haven find roots and find their ground, there will be a lot of work for Pakistani people itself and lift people out of poverty.
In the wake of the coronavirus, I think that there are several changes. First is that the global economy is under kind of a recession. And this is definitely is a sure tendency. And China, that we are working hard to revive our economy.
The construction sector, which has been opened up by this government, will also play a big role, in fact, in reducing poverty. And we have been learning from our friends. We have been focusing on elevation, improvement of health, improvement in education, and therefore, through the same processes, the reduction of poverty.
I think that the Prime Minister Imran Khan made it very clear that the construction sector and that to increase of the employment is the key that for the revival of the after the coronavirus. So I think that this is a part of our CPAC cooperation, because the CPAC, the conception behind the CPAC is a kind of mutual beneficial.
Mr. President, we are going to have more things or important things that we're going to discuss in webinars. Unfortunately, today in Pakistan, in probably most of the world, the importance of webinars, in particularly in this pandemic situation, is not really realized. We have to reach out with all our information. We must take away misconceptions. Thank you, Mr. President. It is my privilege to extend my thanks to you. I would like to say a few words before you leave. And first of all, you know, we are really grateful to you because you have taken time out for this important seminar, and you have said some things which are very important for Pakistan at this juncture, particularly at this critical situation. So I think all in all, we have a great potential in front of us. I cannot thank enough. I must thank His Excellency. He just reached out immediately in the telephone call. It did not take him even 10 seconds to say yes to it. And similarly, General Asim Bajwa immediately said yes to it. I must also thank the Foreign Minister. Without Shah Mahmood Qureshi intervening, this webinar would not have been possible, because he intervened and made sure that this webinar takes place.